Most animals have transport systems for moving fluid, like water or blood, throughout their bodies. In many of these animals, especially those with hearts and blood vessels, we call this the circulatory system. Today, we're going to use visible bodies sea star, earthworm, frog, and pig models to compare transport systems across the animal kingdom. This is super easy to do using the preset views in the Evolution Animal Diversity Unit. Let's start with the sea star. Sea stars have two internal transport systems. They have a hemal system, in which fluid flows through sinuses within tissues, distributing nutrients and monitoring infection. They also have a water vascular system. Here's the sea star's water vascular system in 3D. Water moves through it, allowing sea stars to move, transport food, get rid of waste, and circulate gases. Water enters through the madreporite on the aboral side and flows through a system of canals that connects to the tube feet. We can use tags to point out individual structures. Now we'll move on to the earthworm. Though earthworms are invertebrates like sea stars, they have a closed circulatory system, a major evolutionary step toward more efficient internal transport. Their fluid, blood, is pumped by muscular aortic arches called hearts through blood vessels. As you can see in the model of the earthworm's circulatory system, it's pretty simple for a closed circulatory system. It has only two vessels, a dorsal vessel and a ventral vessel, and five aortic arches which pump blood through them. Earthworms exchange gases with the environment through their skin, so their circulatory system doesn't need to interface with respiratory organs. The frog's circulatory system, also closed, is another step up in complexity. The frog only has one heart, but as you can see in the model, the three-chambered heart and network of blood vessels make up a more specialized circulatory system than the earthworm's. While the frog can absorb oxygen from its environment through its skin, like with the earthworm, it relies on lungs for gas exchange when active on land. Its arteries carry oxygenated blood away from the heart to tissues, and its veins carry deoxygenated blood from tissues to the heart. We'll take a closer look at the frog's heart using the isolate tool. It has two atria and one ventricle. The left atrium receives oxygenated blood from the lungs and skin, and the right atrium receives deoxygenated blood from the rest of the body. Both atria empty into the single ventricle. There is some mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood, but timing and internal structures allow the ventricle to pump more oxygen-poor blood to the lungs and more oxygen-rich blood to the body. The pig's closed circulatory system looks similar to the frog's, but is also a lot more like a human's. We'll go straight to the heart to show you just how human-like it is. The pig's heart is four-chambered, two atria and two ventricles. We can use the draw tool to show how blood moves through the heart. The right atrium receives deoxygenated blood from the body and empties into the right ventricle, which pumps blood to the lungs through pulmonary arteries. The left atrium receives oxygenated blood from the lungs and empties into the left ventricle, which pumps blood to the rest of the body through the aorta. And there you have it, a brief tour of some of the many transport systems the animal kingdom has to offer. Want to compare all of these to the human circulatory system? You can do all that and more with VB Suite. Check it out for yourself at visiblebody.com/VBSuite.